Have you ever wanted to create your own apps, games, or even just understand how coding works? Swift Playgrounds makes learning to code fun, interactive, and accessible, even if you've never typed a line of code in your entire life. Welcome to the Learn to Code with Swift Playgrounds series, a flagship series here on the channel designed specifically to take you from absolute beginner to confident coder. Every week, we'll dive into practical lessons that build your coding skills step by step. By the end of the series, you'll have a solid understanding of fundamental programming concepts using Swift, Apple's powerful yet beginner-friendly coding language. Let's quickly get you set up. Swift Playgrounds is available for free on your Mac or iPad from the App Store. Once you've got it installed, you can open it up and you'll see that we have this Learn to Code button here. There's lots of different sample apps for you to explore, but we're going to be focusing on Learn to Code 1 and Learn to Code 2 first. You want to select them and press the Get button. Once you've done that, they should download and appear on your main menu. And just as a note, whether you're working on Mac or iPad, it's the exact same course either way. Before we jump into coding, let's quickly talk about what commands are. Commands are like simple instructions that we give to a computer. Think of it like telling your character exactly what you want to do. I like to imagine it as if I'm giving directions to a friend. Turn left, walk forward, or jump. Commands in code work the exact same way, and we also need to write them in the correct order. So we're going to start off by writing commands to move our friend Byte here within a puzzle world in order to perform tasks. We're going to have Byte also collect gems. Just as a quick note, we can see here that the commands are kind of like mashed together words. Code is punctuated in space like human languages, but commands actually have no spaces between them and start with a lowercase letter. Commands are also always going to end in parentheses, and we'll see why in a future video. Let's go ahead and start coding. All right, on our first lesson here, we can see that we have our friend Byte, and he has a few spaces in front of him. He needs to go through the puzzle world and collect the gem. We have our instructions on the left, and we have our code editor right underneath. We can click to enter the code, and you can either choose to type on your device, or at the bottom of the screen here, we can kind of see that we have the collect gem and move forward commands available to us. It's totally up to you. I usually recommend selecting these options just to prevent any spelling mistakes. We have to be very intentional, as if we have a spelling mistake, our code won't run because Byte won't know what to do. So we need to move forward 1, 2, 3 times, and then we need to collect the gem. So let's do 3 move forward commands and then the collect gem command. At the bottom of the screen, there's the run my code option, and we can have Byte move forward and collect the gem. Now, as I mentioned before, he does need to do these commands in order. So if we had the collect gem at the start, we wouldn't actually collect that gem. So congratulations, you've actually just written your first lines of Swift code. I performed the commands in the exact order that we gave them. Let's navigate to the next page. If you ever get lost, there is the tab at the top left that has all the lessons that we're working through. You can also use the top bar here to go back and forth as well. We can see that Byte has to take a little bit of a turn to collect the gem, and we've got introduced to a new command here at the bottom, turn left. This command is going to allow Byte to kind of shift their direction, and depending on their direction, they'll then be able to move forward. So we have one move forward command already given to us. We need to go 2 spaces in front, so let's go ahead and add another move forward. If we were to move forward again, we'd end up on this rock, and I don't think we want to be there. So let's go ahead and try to turn left. We'll then want to move forward 1, 2 more times. So let's do 2 more move forwards. And then we should be under the gem in order to collect it. Let's go ahead and test this out. So he moves forward 1, 2 times. He's then going to turn left, move forward 2 more times, and collect the gem. Awesome. We've written more complex code. We've added another command into our system, and we're able to turn Byte and have him complete the puzzle. Let's explore the next page. We have a little bit more of a complex puzzle, but I'm pretty sure we'll be able to get through this. The goal of this puzzle, as we can see in the top here, is asking us not only to collect the gem, but also toggle on the switch. We're pros with our commands already, so let's figure out how we can get Byte there. I'm also just going to turn my camera so we can kind of see the tiles a little bit better. So once again, we need to move forward twice. We're then going to need to turn Byte, collect the gem, and then we're going to continue on our journey in order to get Byte to the switch. So let's move forward twice. We'll then turn left, move forward again. That should place us right under this gem. We'll collect it, move forward another space, which should put us right kind of here where my mouse cursor is. Then we'll need to turn left, move forward two more times, and then toggle the switch. So all of these commands that we're issuing, again, I'm not even typing these, I am just selecting them from the bottom of the screen. If you're working on the iPad, sometimes when you do press on the code editor area, it'll kind of be on the top of your keyboard, which is really handy. Okay, so let's run our code and see what happens. So once again, we're gonna move forward again, turn left, we're gonna move forward, collect the gem, move forward, turn left, two more move forwards, switch, Byte does his little jump, and he's been issued the correct commands. See how the order of these commands is super important. We're kind of giving a list of instructions to Byte, and he's executing them in the exact same way. All right, portal practice. So we can see here that we have some portals on the screen for Byte to explore, and these are going to allow him to teleport from one area to another. We're going to be using all the commands that we've learned so far in order to have Byte reach the end gem. So let's take this one step at a time. We need to move forward three times. So let's go ahead and add those three commands. We'll then need to turn Byte left. Let's add our turn left command. Move forward two more times to get to a switch. We'll toggle said switch. Let's go ahead and move forward after, and that's going to put us through the teleporter. I'm not sure which direction we're going to be facing when we go through the teleporter, so we can always just run our code to experiment. We're going to run our code. He's going to go through the commands we've issued. I'm going to toggle the switch. Go through the teleporter. So it appears that Byte's still facing the same direction when he comes out the teleporter. So let's figure out what we need to do. He needs to go straight. He then needs to turn left, go forward two more times, and collect the gem. We don't have to rewrite our entire block of code, as when we run our code, we'll notice that Byte goes all the way back to the beginning where he originally started. So let's move forward, turn left, two more move forwards, and a gem collection. So now when we run our code, Byte's going to go ahead and reset all the way back here. Our switch state has also been reset. Every time we run the code, it's kind of like a blank slate. He's toggling his switch, going through the portal. He's turning left. He's kind of getting cut off there on screen. And then there we go, selecting his gem. And we have solved the first challenge. Although we've kind of been through a lot of different challenges, but that's portal practice done. So when we write code, it is very, very easy to make mistakes. Take it from me. Can't tell you how many times I make a mistake while coding. Mistake keeps our program from running correctly, and we refer to this as a bug. And finding and fixing bugs is a process called debugging. So we're given actually some commands on the left side here, and our job is to drag the commands into the correct location. We can rewrite it if we want, test the code, and run it again. So let's kind of see what happens with Byte. He's going to move forward, going to turn left, move forward again. Oh, he's trying to collect a gem. It's not there, Byte. It's not there. He's moving forward. He's toggling a switch. Ah, we're very close. I believe what's happening is we're turning left too early. So we're going forward, turning left, moving. Let's go ahead and take these commands. And what you can do is you can highlight them with your mouse or highlight them with your finger on the iPad. And we can actually drag and change the order of these operations. So let's move this move forward up. So we should go forward one, two times. He's then going to turn left, move forward, collect the gem, move forward, and toggle the switch. It was a really simple mistake, but I think that one fix would be the solution. And that's why we run our code. We want to test it and make sure that it works, because often there might be one or two little bugs we haven't noticed along the way, and testing and debugging is a huge part of coding. A great job in solving your first bug in the code. All right, in bug squash practice, watch out, one of the switches on this map actually starts open. So the switch in front of us, we can see here, is actually currently toggled on. So we need to do a little bit more bug squashing. It also might be a good idea every time that we make a change to run our code so we can see how it's being impacted. See here, I don't think we want to toggle that switch. Wait, where are you going? What gems are you collecting? Oh no, okay. I think I know what we need to do. Feels that we have all the right commands. They're just once again in a little bit of the incorrect order. So let's highlight our turn left and let's drag it to the second command. So move forward, turn left, move forward twice, toggle a switch, and let's see how this now runs. And if we have to make any more changes, we'll just run and fix it again. We're going to go forward, toggle a switch, two more forwards, it's going to teleport, go again. Ah, we're so close. The bug is just having us collect the gem a little too late. Let's go ahead and solve that. Move this collect gem all the way down to the very bottom, and we should have the correct solution now. As a note, if Byte's moving a little bit too slow at the very bottom left, we can actually have him run even faster. Byte's going a little quick, he's going hyperspeed, but if you're finding that the puzzles are moving too slow, that is an option. So great job, we have found all the bugs in the code. And this is the last chapter in commands. We have a challenge, evaluate options and pick the shortest route. For the last challenge, we're going to make Byte move around in a bigger and more complicated world. Holy smokes, there is a lot going on here. We need to actually figure out the shortest route for Byte to pick up the gem, toggle and open the switch, and we can use one or both of the portals. So we have a green portal that's going to take us to the green and the blue to the blue. I think the shortest solution is we just beeline it straight to the gem, go through the portal and then hit the toggle. So I'm going to move forward 1, 2, 3 times. We're going to then collect the gem. I'm going to move forward twice. That should put us through the teleporter. Move forward two more times. And then toggle the switch. Let's go ahead and test it out. There we go. He's going on his little journey. And I'm going to go a little bit faster. Going through the portal. And toggle the switch. And there we go. It says I found the shortest route, but if you did find one shorter, let me know in the comments below. That's it for commands. Today you've learned about commands, your first coding concept. As a quick debugging or troubleshooting, if your character isn't moving, double check that your spelling and capitalization is correct. I was trying to move forward and I had even the A kind of wrong, right? You'll notice that we get a little red dot next to our code, which says can't find move forward in scope. Essentially, Byte doesn't know that command. I recommend just using these options down here for now. We'll get to type and customize our code in future versions. Thanks for coding along with me. Remember, coding is all about experimenting and having fun. I'll see you in the next video where we tackle functions.